Hi, in this short episode, we will talk about internal and external software testing. Internal software testing we discuss in detail, which is whitebox testing, where we are sitting right inside the code and we have access to all the DTOs, all the repositories, classes, services, controller, everything. So we had access to that because we were sitting right inside the code in a different folder or in a different package, which is the test, and we were able to access it. And we only not able to launch the unit test from inside. We were also were able to launch the integration test, and we were mocking everything which was going outside of the boundary of a single service, but we were testing all the layers together. But when we talk about the external testing, we have to have a separate project. So this is the practice that is followed for the black box testing or external testing. We usually write or create a separate project where we write the code which is not aware of the internal structure. So if some API is returning ID, name, etc. in a JSON format, so you have to create an equivalent object or a class to receive or to hold that information. So maybe you have to copy paste the same DTOs, or you can create on your own. So that's two different perspectives. One is knowing everything and launching the test from within the application. Another one is you just go at a very high level, you look at the input and output, so it's more like a black box testing and your system is separate. So when we run the pipeline, when we compile the code, so internal software testing is executed like unit test and integration test. So it can run on the compile time, or even when you create a branch, if you create a PR, so in that PR you might trigger these unit and integration tests. And if we keep the pipeline like extended, so once the deployment is done on a certain environment, so you may run a set of black box tests like end-to-end test, or you can run the system-wide test on a specific environment which tests different aspects. So it's just to make sure that those tests were successful. Again, an important thing to notice here, so maybe you might not run everything like all the end-to-end tests, because it might going to cost you, it might not be suitable for you to create certain items on the production, so your test may contain everything. So this is very important when you build your pipeline. So you might have different environment, dev, QA stage. So there could be a couple of tests you can run on the QA environment, another test on the stage. So when we go step by step, there might be change in the type of test or the scope of the test that we are running. So let's say if something is deployed in the production and if there is an automated test, so it would be a sort of sanity test which might not create anything. So it could be read-only, so it may navigate from places to places, or it may call read-only APIs to test if system is working, but it might not be wise to create some junk data on the production, etc. So these are two broader categories, like external and internal software testing. QAs and developer usually write them. Sometimes developers go beyond that and they create a separate project for the black box testing because they want to ensure the quality. That's it for today. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye.